Okay, hi guys, welcome to PVL2602, which is the law of succession. We're going to be looking at assignment one for 2021, which is the super semester. So we're going to focus on question two, the one about Tabo and Sonia and the whole will situation. I had no intention of doing this question because I thought that the hardest one was the first one, which we did in the other video. But I got a lot of requests, people were reaching out and asking us to do question two. So I'm happy to say that I've obliged to that. And this is the question that we're going to look at. So what we're going to do today is I'm just going to give you a brief guideline on the things that you should look out for. We're still going to encourage you guys to go back to your books and try to formulate this in your own way so that it does feel like it's your own work. So I'm just going to give a brief a skeleton, so to speak, of the things that I thought you should focus on. That is going to be the main aim of this video, of this tutorial, just to give you guys a guideline on how to deal with question two. So I keep asking you guys to share this information so that we all benefit from it, and to subscribe as well so that you're the first people to get videos every time that we post any new stuff. Okay, so to just get straight into it, I'm not going to like to read the whole question, but I'm just going to focus on the parts that we should cover. I think it's important, because this is such a long question, it's important to break it down so that you know the things that you should be focusing on. So I've broken down the question into, I think, is it four parts? Okay, so the first part, I'm going to answer what you're going to advise Tabo's parents. That's the first part. And then the second part explains the course of action that you're going to take as the attorney and all possible arguments that you're going to raise in the matter. And then thirdly, we're going to explain the chances of succeeding with our suggested course of action. And then during the process, we'll be referring to relevant case law as well to support our arguments. Okay, so that is the format or the way that we're going to approach this question. So on the first part that says, what are you going to advise them? Okay, so the advice is that there are grounds on which Tabo's will, or the will that Tabo left, may be challenged. So it's important for you guys to understand that what we're trying to do is we're trying to invalidate this will so that his estate can devolve following the rules of interstate succession. In other words, once we find this will invalid, what follows is that Tabo would have died without a will, and then his parents, being his only surviving relatives, would then get the benefit from the will. Because remember, Tabo left no spouse and left no descendants. So once this will is invalid, what it means is that a court will declare that Tabo died without a will. And when that happens, his parents, which in this case the parents are our clients, will get his estate. So there are various grounds, just to generally speaking, there are various grounds on which wills may be challenged. This include a testator's capacity. This can, when we speak of capacity, it could be his age. Remember, his or her age. Remember, you have to be 16 to be able to make a will. In this case, Tabo is okay on that because it's 30, but just generally speaking, that can count as well. And capacity can also include a testator's mental capacity when they made the will. Another factor might be the requisite formalities that are prescribed by Section 2 of the Wills Act. You might want to read on that as well, so that just you understand what they look for. And then another situations, it can be forgery, testamentary capacity, which I've just spoken about, undue influence, and so on. So this is just generally speaking things that can be used to challenge the validity of a will. Those things that I've just mentioned, I was just speaking generally. Now we're going to go to the next part of the question that says, what course of action, explain the course of action that you're going to take and all possible arguments that you're going to raise in this matter. Okay, so the first step is obviously to bring an application in the High Court challenging the validity of Tabo's will. So what we're going to be discussing next are the grounds on which to base the claims of invalidity. What are we going to bring to the court to say this is why we think Thabo's will should be ruled to be invalid? Okay, so the first point that I'm gonna share with you guys is animus testandi, or the intention to make a will. Okay, so having animus testandi is a core requirement for the validity of a will. It's clear from the facts given, from the facts that were given on the question, that Thabo legged animus testandi, because the question, the set of facts actually say Sonia urged him to make a will. In other words, she made him make the will. So he had no intention in the first place to make the will. That on itself is a core requirement for making a valid will. So what it means is that because Thabo legged animus testandi, what it means is that his will is invalid ab initio. Ab initio is a Latin term that means from start to the end. So from the beginning to the end, Thabo's will is invalid because he legged the intention to make the will in the first place. So that is the first argument that we're going with. And our second argument, remember, we're still on the course of action and all possible arguments that we can raise in this matter. So our second argument is fraud. Okay, so as we give these grounds, I'm also referring to authority, to the cases, to the relevant case law that the question asked about. So so we're just like covering two parts of the question at once, like killing two birds with one stone. So in Spies versus Smith, which is a case for you to refer to, the court explained that a testator may be convinced with flattery and declarations of love. In other words, you can flatter someone on their deathbed or before they make a will. You can say nice things to them. You can even declare your love for them. That's fine, as long as it keeps within those flattery and declarations of love or humiliation as well, it's fine. But once these actions take the form of fraud, this leads to the invalidity of a will. So because Sonia lied to Thabo that she was expecting their child, that being fraudulent in itself, the lie, Thabo left his estate to them, which is the girlfriend Sonia and their supposed child on the way. He left his entire estate to them, acting on false information that Sonia was pregnant. So that in itself is fraudulent, and that in itself can lead to the invalidity of a will. So that is the second point, that is the second argument that we're bringing. Okay, so the next point that we're going to bring, the next argument that we're going to bring, is testamentary capacity. On this one, I'm going to ask you guys to read Section 4 of the Wills Act just to have an understanding of what it is. Okay, so Thabo legged the sufficient mental capacity to understand the nature and effect of his act. He also failed from the set of facts that were given. We read that he also failed to recognize his parents at some point, the same parents whose interests were affected by his will. So it's important when you deal with testamentary capacity to understand when it's important to be of sound mind. Okay, so the decisive moment for establishing the competence of a testator is the time the will is made. In other words, it doesn't matter what a person does after, it doesn't matter how a person behaves before, it's how they behave during the drafting of the will. So Thabo legged this competence as shown by the set of facts that say that he was delirious and at times was in a state of confusion. Imagine a person who's so delirious to the point that they do not even recognize their parents, and we're speaking of a 30-year-old. So this is an important point as well, an important argument as well, that actually invalidates Thabo's will. Okay, so next point, and this one is important because it actually takes a bit of explaining. So the argument here is the role of undue influence on a person's volition. In other words, the role of undue influence on a testator's choice. So the point here is that a test taker must decide on his or her own free will how his estate must devolve. In question v. Bailey, the court outlined the role of undue influence on a testator's volition. In cases where a testator is no longer a compos mentis means of sound mind, like how Tabo was, undue influence can affect a testator's volition such that a testator no longer expresses his or her own free will, which is sometimes called a displacement of volition, but the wishes of someone else, in this case Sonia. Now, because so this is the part that I said needs a bit of explaining. I'll try to do that. Because Tabo was vulnerable, he was in a state where he was confused and delirious, it allowed Sonia to unduly influence him by making sure that her wishes are the ones that are expressed in Tabo's will. Surely Tabo would have left something for his parents if it was his own free will. This is just an assumption, but he wasn't even married to Sonia at that point. So the fact that she lied to him, the fact that she got her wishes into the will, points to invalidity on the grounds that her wishes displaced the choice or the volition of Tabo. So that's another ground as well on which we can argue for the invalidation of this will. Okay, so still on the possible arguments that can be raised, I've just outlined three things that I've named other factors. So these are some of the factors that a court may look into when they're trying to decide whether or not a will is valid or not. Okay, so the first one is a testator's ability to resist influence. I've already touched on this when I spoke of undue influence, and when I say that Tabo was in a state of confusion, he didn't have his wits about him, he was delirious. So that in itself, that weakness might affect his ability to resist any sort of influence that may come from another person. And then the second point is the relationship between the testator and a person responsible for the alleged influence. In other words, the relationship between the testator and the people that are involved in the will. What this does is, sometimes when people are close, when a person they have a sexual relationship, like what Tabo had with Sonia, a person like that may easily influence a testator because of the proximity of their relationship, because of how close they are. So that's a point as well that a court may look into. And then thirdly, and very important as well, is the period between, this is very important, the period between the drafting of the will and the death of the testator. What this means is that a court may look at the time. Of course, in this case, Tabo died the next day after drafting the will. So that's another ground for us to ask, as in ask the lawyers and Tabo's parents to base our arguments, because what it basically means is that if a person drafts a will today and dies tomorrow, they do not have the time, you know, to decide if this is the will that they want. They do not have the time to change it. They do not have the time to amend it. But if a person makes a will today and then they die, say, a month later, it's easy to accept that will as their final will and testament, because their time, you know, between writing it and dying to actually change it, which they did not. So in this case, Tabo had no time to do that. So it makes it easier for us to argue that it wasn't his last will and testament. It wasn't his will. It wasn't his intention for his estate to devolve the way that it did. So it's another important point there to point out as well, when you speak of all the possible arguments that you can raise in trying to invalidate the will that Tabo left. Okay, so lastly, on the chances of success, there's a point that I didn't really understand. I didn't really know what they expected us to do or what they're expecting us to do. But what I can say is that the important things to note here as well. The first one is that it's important to acknowledge that the will that Tabo left actually satisfies all the required formalities that are set forth in Section 2 of the Wills Act. He signed it, he had the witnesses as well who signed it. So I've had people raise arguments about the nurses and all that. I think it's important to note, even in your assignment, that this will actually satisfied all the requirements that are set in the will, in Section 2 of the Wills Act. You might want to read on that as well, just to get an appreciation of what those requirements are. And then it is also important to note that in challenges such as the one that we're bringing, just like it is in all other civil cases, the evidentiary burden of a challenge to invalidate a will lies on the person who alleges that the will is invalid. In other words, Tabo's parents and their lawyer bear the burden to prove the grounds that we've been speaking about. The burden of proof is on us to be able to invalidate the will, to prove the invalidity of the will. However, because of the arguments that we've brought forward, there are a lot of arguments from fraud to lack of testamentary capacity, lack of animus testandi, lack of volition, all the things that we've been speaking about. It's important, I think, to accept that our chances are pretty high, that they're good, basing just on the number of grounds that we've brought that we can use to invalidate Tabo as well. So this is the end of this tutorial. I hope you guys find it helpful. Just on the screen there now, I think you can see our contact details. If you feel you need to send us an email, this is the email address. Our YouTube channel is UNISA LLB Student Support. You can always reach out, leave comments, leave a thumbs up, tell us what you like, tell us what you don't like. And then I'm also on Instagram. I am Fran263. You can follow me there and send a message if you need to reach out as well. So thank you guys for listening. I hope you find this helpful, and please share, please subscribe, so that you're the first to get notifications when we post new material. Thank you.